Hello, welcome to the Joy Smiles Art, Art of Joy Smiles portion of this fundraiser. I just want to express not only my gratitude to be a part of this online festival, but my gratitude for the Art Wildlife Care and Sanctuary who helps those that cannot speak for when they need help. The RadioCave family, the Earthdance global family, Foundation of Families, these are all really phenomenal groups of people that are trying to speak out for those with quiet voices, no voices, and that those that just need a little bit more help sometimes. So what better way to celebrate, bring recognition, awareness to such a beautiful cause, helping out those in need and helping out those who help those like animals who cannot speak for themselves. During this fundraiser, we have a few giveaways here with Joy Smiles Art before we get into the painting. We really appreciate you being part of the RadioCave family. And we really appreciate the way that not only all of you sponsors, you wonderful people who donate to these different causes, so we may help others. And I want to give back. So in a gracious way from myself and from RadioCave, Joy Smiles Art and RadioCave would like to offer three prizes. We have this mini original. I do love the tetrahedron star. It is one of my favorites, and I just wanted to represent a beautiful evening, a beautiful morning, full of stars, wonder, and magic. That is an original piece. It is acrylic on canvas. Another prize that we are offering here from Joy Smiles Art is a print and pen of a RadioCave inspired creation, Brain Food. Brain Food was brought to my mind and brought to life because RadioCave found a phenomenal organization, One Mind, Align One Mind, and they support, bring awareness to those suffering from traumatic brain injuries. So with another prize, you get that pin. You can wear it like a brooch, you can attach it to things, and some people like myself, we collect them. So I have a pin board at home. And here we have the brain food. I'm gonna bring the print back up here, and this is a package. These two together, the brain here is represented in the shape of the heart, because our brain needs love and our heart needs love. The left side is left more analytical looking, just a touch of whimsical, but just what you would imagine a brain looking like. And then the right side of the brain, the more creative side of the brain, or so they say, has a little bit of love, joy, hope, creation, and sight. I put the eye there, not only to represent the eye of our hearts, the eye of our brain, and the eyes of our soul. We don't just use the eyes on our face to see, we use so much more. So Brain Food was created in 2021. I'm looking at just the print that I signed. I was really honored to be able to not only create this piece, give away the original in a RadioCave fundraiser, just like this. So thank you to those donating throughout this live showing, throughout any of our fundraisers. We really just appreciate it because without people like you, we would not create sometimes the magic we're able to create. The last package I wanted to present here is going to be three prints. These are just examples. I'm going to get some that I haven't been traveling around with. I do a lot of music festivals, but we have three pieces that were inspired by RadioCave. This one was for the ARC in 2021. I was really honored to create this piece. This is Mysis, and I believe that is a lion god and a lion goddess in Egyptian, if I'm not mistaken. We have Believe in Community. Be Leaving Community, if I'm not mistaken, was my first piece that I donated an original, a print to Radio Cave members like yourselves when they donate it. This is Breathe, which is a watercolor piece. The original, again, was given away in a Radio Cave fundraiser. And this one here was to bring awareness and just so much more to those suffering with cystic fibrosis. I found out during that fundraiser so much more. And the main thing that really just stuck with me is I was so shocked that the first thing it likes to attack are your lungs. And I am so lucky to be able to breathe and breathe the way that I do and be able to speak so loudly and boisterous when needed. So that is your last package. So Joy Smiles Art and Radio Cave are sending out three winners during this broadcast, after this broadcast, these beautiful prizes. I'm really honored to be a part of these fundraisers. And again, we are celebrating with Earthdance Global Pray for Peace 2023, hashtag Wild Life Rescue Nexus, Radio Cave, Foundation of Families, and the Ark Wildlife Care and Sanctuary. We are here to speak for those that do not have the words to speak for themselves. We really appreciate you being here. I'm going to do a little bit of painting, and I'm also going to try to read you guys some of this beautiful story. So before I dive too far in, I'm going to paint for a little bit, then I'm going to read this beautiful story to you. It is a story called The Little Soul in the Sun, a children's parable adapted from Conversations with God, Neil Donald Walsh. I'm really grateful to be an artist, to be able to share my art like this. This here is one of my budding eyes. The budding eyes are eye flowers that were created to remind us that within the growth within us and outside of us, we bloom with our sight, with our chakras aligned, with all the beautiful rainbows that we see throughout our lives. Rainbows, regardless of where you are in the world, they all represent hope. A rainbow represents hope in its simplest form. Really grateful to have started painting back in 2017. Painting with passion. Some like to ask me, when did you start painting like this? Usually my response is, I started painting with passion in 2017. A friend of mine inspired me to paint a few things, and a few people asked me to buy those paintings. These were very random, got a little paint on my hand. These were very random people I did not know, but one of them, and it was such a spark. It just kind of came out of me. I started painting more and more and more and more. I started spending the little bit of money I had on canvases and anything I could that I thought that might inspire me to paint something out of my soul. And thank goodness I had and have such a huge group of friends that inspire me. They inspire me to be better. They inspire me to be my absolute best in everything that I do. I believe here at Radio Cave and at Joy Smiles Art, we really just want everyone to find the art and heart within themselves. Heart as a physical object, yes, but so much more than that. You have heart in everything that you do and everything that you are. If you see the heart inside yourself, you will find something that brings you eternal joy. art is anything that is created to inspire, to let others feel something you feel. I really truly think art is the way we communicate with those that don't speak the same language, that those that don't have the same education, with these type of creations, be it sculpture. I got blue all over my hands. Yes, this is a normal thing. Without art, where are we as a people? Art is something that's left over after every civilization is gone. There is always art left over to speak for those that are no longer. I am so grateful for passion that comes out in bright colors. I am so grateful for passion that flies out of my soul in such random moments. It's hard to know when I might be inspired or shook by a creative bug. It could be at 4:30 in the afternoon. It could be at 6:30 in the a.m. It could be after a night of partying, a night at the bar, and I am inspired. Inspired to create, inspired to sing out my soul. How do you sing out your soul? How do you sing out your soul? Do you do it with song? Do you do it with words? Do you do it with art? Do you do it? We're here to live. We're not here just to exist. We have to find our whys. I think sometimes it's easier to find those whys. Your partner, your child, your pet, your parents. Whatever your why might be, speak it proudly. Speak it daily. Love freely. Love the animals and love yourself. Love. Utter. Love. Be love and you will find love. Be the love you want to find in the world outside you. You are so much more powerful than you think in your own head. You are so much more than just a body. You are so much more than just a soul. You are so much more than just a woman. You are so much more than just a man. You are infinite. You are the universe. One thing that always stuck with me from Buddhism, I don't really claim anything other than I believe that there is a God. I believe they have let us experience this human experience through this physical form to learn love and compassion and patience and heart and so much. I want to have love and compassion for my neighbor. I want to feel that same from others. And if I do not, I will not be angry. Find peace in those frustrating moments. Find peace in the darkness. Find peace in the light. Find peace within you. So there's this statue of Buddha, and that's what I was touching on. He is laughing gutturally. You can just It's just such a hearty expression, such a deep looking laugh. And as I was explained to before, this statue represents a moment where Buddha looked so far deep inside himself on a meditation that he started laughing. I'm gonna cry. He started laughing because he said, God was within me all along. So don't search for God outside of yourself. Don't search for the universe outside of yourself. You will find it in others and in yourself. You will find it in rocks and in flowers and in movies and in cake and in your favorite meal, your favorite laughter, your favorite joke, your favorite song. You will find love in everything and everyone. You will find God in everything and in everyone. It is so easy to love others sometimes and hard to love yourself. Please don't forget to love yourself. We need you to pour from a full cup whenever possible, because you deserve a cup that is full. You have earned a cup that is full. So remember, don't pour your cup out all at once. And when you feel that you are almost out of joy, of love, of whatever it is you feel like you are missing in that moment, you are not. You are love. You are peace. You are everything. We are existence. Our existence is ridiculous. Our existence is fabulous. It's wild that we even exist on this twirling planet through space. I am honored that passion flows through my heart and my mind and comes out in my hands. So grateful. Our background music today is, this is the Music Lab Collective. It was on Spotify underneath the uncopyrighted music that you're allowed to play and things like this. Really grateful for you guys listening. This is my newest piece and I really want to share with you while I'm letting that dry for just a moment, some of this story. So this story is The Little Sun, The Little Soul, and The Sun. It's a children's parable adapted from Conversations with God, Neil Donald Walsh, and illustrated by Frank Rico. It is a beautiful, beautiful book. Once upon a time, once upon no time, there was a little soul who said to God, I know who I am. And God said, that's wonderful. Who are you? The little soul shouted, I am the light. God smiled a big smile. That's right, God explained. You are the light. The little soul was happy, for it had figured out what all the little souls in the kingdom were there to figure out. Wow, said the little soul, this is really cool. But soon, knowing who it was not enough. The little soul felt stirrings inside and now wanted to be who it was. And so the little soul went back to God, which is not a bad idea for all souls who want to be who they really are. and said, "Hi, God. Now that I know who I am, is it okay for me to be it?" And God said, "You mean you want to be who you already are?" "Well," replied the little soul, "it's one thing to know who I am and another thing altogether to actually be it. I want to feel what it's like to be the light." "But you already are the light," God repeated, smiling again. "Yes, but I want to see what it feels like," cried the little soul. "Well," God said with a chuckle, "I suppose I should have known. You always were the adventurous one." Then God's expression changed. "There's only one thing." "What?" asked the little soul. "Well, there's nothing else but the light. You see, I created nothing but what you are, and so there is no easy way for you to experience yourself as who you are, since there is nothing that you are not." "Huh?" said the little soul, who was now a little confused. "Think of it this way," said God. "You are like a candle in the sun. You're right there, all right, along with a million kajillion other candles who make up the sun. And the sun would not be the sun without you. Nay, it would be a sun without one of its candles, and that would not be the sun at all, for it would not shine as brightly. Yet how to know yourself as the light when you are amidst the light, that is the question." "Well," the little soul perked up, "you are God. I mean, think of something." "Once more," God smiled. "I already have," God said. "Since you cannot see yourself as the light when you are in the light, surround you in darkness." "What's darkness?" the little soul asked. God replied, "It is that which you are not." "Will I be afraid of the dark?" cried the little soul. "Only if you choose to be," God answered. "There is nothing really to be afraid of, unless you decide that there is. You see, we are all making it all up. We are pretending." "Oh," said the little soul, and felt better already. Then God explained that in order to experience anything at all, the exact opposite of it will appear. "It is a great gift," God said, "because without it, you could not know what anything is like. You could not know warm without cold, up without down, fast without slow. You could not know left without right, here without there, now without then." "And so," God concluded, "when you are surrounded with darkness, do not shake your fist and raise your voice and curse the darkness. Rather be a light unto the darkness. Don't be mad about it, and then you'll know who you really are, and others will know too. Let your light shine so that everyone will know how special you are." "You mean it's okay to let others see how special I am?" asked the little soul. "Of course," God chuckled. "It's very okay, but remember, special does not mean better. Everybody is special, each in their own way. Yet many others have forgotten that. They will see it as okay for them to be special only when you say that it's okay for you to be special." "Wow," said the little soul, dancing and skipping and laughing. Tried not to cry. "And jumping with joy. I can be as special as I want to be." "Yes, and you can start right now," said God, who was dancing and skipping and laughing right along with the little soul. "What part of special do you want to be?" "What part of special?" the little soul repeated. "I don't understand." Well, God explained. "Being the light is being special, and being special has a lot of parts to it. It is special to be kind. It is special to be gentle. It is special to be creative. It is special to be patient. Can you think of any other way as it is to be special?" The little soul sat quietly for a moment. "I can think of lots of ways to be special," the little soul exclaimed. "It is special to be helpful. It is special to be sharing. It is special to be friendly. It is special to be considerate of others." "Yes," God agreed. "And you can be all of those things or any part of special you wish to be at any moment.
If at any time you would like to reframe the word God with universe or source, that is totally fine. It is a word that some use as representation of the source, of the light, of that God.
I know what I want to be. I know what I want to be, said the little soul announced with great excitement. I want to be the part of special called forgiving. Isn't it special
to be forgiving?
Oh, yes. The universe assured the little soul that it is very special. Okay, said the little soul. That's what I want to be. I want to be forgiving. I want to experience myself as that. Good, said God. But there's one thing you should know. The little soul was becoming a little bit impatient now. It always seemed as though there was some complication. What is it? The little soul sighed. There is no one to forgive. No one. The little soul could hardly believe what had been said. No one? God repeated. Everything I have made is perfect. There's not a single soul in all creation less perfect than you. Look around you. It was then that the little soul realized a large crowd had gathered. Souls had come far wide from all over the kingdom for the word that had gone forth. The little soul was having this extraordinary conversation with God. And everyone wanted to hear what they were saying. Looking at the countless other souls gathered there, the little soul had to agree. None appeared less wonderful, less magnificent, or less perfect than the little soul itself. Such was the wonder of the souls gathered around, and so bright was their light, that the little soul could scarcely gaze upon them. Who then to forgive? Asked God. Boy, this is going to be no fun at all, grumbled the little soul. I wanted to experience myself as one who forgives. I wanted to know what that part of special felt like. And the little soul learned what it must feel like to be sad. But just then a friendly soul stepped forward from the crowd. Not to worry, little soul, the friendly soul said. I will help you. This is a beautiful story, and I'm a very emotional woman, and I will try not to cry as much as possible so you can understand what I'm reading. You will, the little soul brightened, but what can you do? Why, I can give you someone to forgive. Why, I can give you someone to forgive. You can. Certainly, I can come into your next lifeline and do something for you to forgive. But why? Why would you do that? The little soul asked. You who are a being of such utter perfection, you who vibrate with such a speed that it creates a light so bright that I can hardly gaze upon you. What could cause you to want to slow down your vibration to such a speed that your bright light would become dark and dense? What could cause you, who are so light that you dance upon the stars and move throughout the kingdom with the speed of your thought, to come into my life and make yourself so heavy that you could do this bad thing? Simple, the friendly soul said. I would do it because I love you. The little soul seemed surprised at the answer. Don't be so amazed, said the friendly soul. You have done the same thing for me. Don't you remember? Oh, we have danced together, you and I, many times. Through the eons and across all the ages we have danced. Across all time and in many places. One moment, guys. We have both been all of it. You just don't remember. We have been the up and the down of it, the left and the right of it. We have been the here and the there of it, the now and the then of it. We have been the male and the female, the good and the bad. We have both been the victim and the villain of it. Thus have we come together, you and I, many times before. each bringing to the other the exact and perfect opportunity to express and to experience who we really are. And so on. The friendly soul explained a little further. I will come into your next lifeline, and I be the bad one this time. I will do something really terrible, and then you can experience yourself as the one who forgives. But what will you do? The little soul asked, just a little nervously. That would be so terrible. Oh, the friendly soul with a twinkle. We'll think of something. And then the friendly soul seemed to turn serious and said in the quiet voice, you're right about one thing, you know. What is that? The little soul wanted to know. I will have to slow down my vibration and become very heavy to do this not so nice thing. I will have to pretend to be something very unlike myself. And so I have but one favor to ask you in return. Oh, anything, anything, cried the little soul and began to dance and sing. I get to be forgiving. I get to be forgiving. Then the little soul saw that the friendly soul was remaining very quiet. What is it? The little soul asked. What can I do for you? You are such an angel to be willing to do this for me. Of course, this friendly soul is an angel, God interpreted. Everyone is. Always remember, I have sent you nothing but angels. And so the little soul wanted more than ever to grant the friendly soul's request. What can I do for you? The little soul asked again. In the moment that I strike you and smite you, the friendly soul replied, in the moment that I do the worst to you that you could possibly imagine, in that very moment. Yes. Yes, said the little soul. Yes. The friendly soul became quieter still. Remember who I really am. Oh, I will, cried the little soul. I promise I will always remember you as I see you right here, right now. Good, said the friendly soul, because you see, I will have been pretending so hard, I will have forgotten myself, and if you do not remember me as I really am, I might not be able to remember for a very long time, and if I forget who I am, you may never forget who you are, and we will both be lost, and you may even forget who you are. And we will both be lost. When we will need another soul to come along and remind us both of who we are. No, we won't, the little soul promised again. I will remember you and I will thank you for bringing me this gift. The chance to experience myself as who I am. And so the agreement was made. And the little soul went forth into a new lifetime. Excited to be the light, which was very special, and excited to be the part of special called forgiveness. And the little soul waited anxiously to be able to experience itself as forgiveness and to thank what other soul made it possible. And all the moments in that new lifetime, whenever a new soul appeared on the scene, whenever that new soul brought joy or sadness, and especially if it brought sadness, the little soul thought of what God had said. Always remember, God had smiled. I have sent you nothing but angels. Thank you for listening to me. I felt that this group of people, out of many that I could share this with, that you would get something out of it. A dear friend of mine, Cynthia Gomez, and I are celebrating later this year in December, the Lotus Gathering. It is going to be incredible down in Brooksville, Florida. I will look forward to sharing so much more about that in my art group, Art of Joy Smiles. And Nicholas and the Radio Cave group are so great about getting with me, getting that information out to you all. A great way to find me is at JoySmilesArt, Instagram. I don't share much on, Twitter. If you'd like to leave me a gift or a tip, feel free to do so. Venmo and Cash App. I also show up on PayPal as joysmilesart@gmail.com. When in doubt, find your joy. Don't let others steal your joy. Don't let yourself steal your joy. Find joy within yourself and everyone that you meet. Because if you can find joy in those little moments, and you can find joy in the middle of nowhere, you can find joy at a zoo, you can find joy at the library, you can find joy anywhere you look, if you're looking for it. Happiness is a choice. Now, things happen to all of us. It's all in how we react. We are not walking in each other's shoes. Remember to be kind, because in that moment you are struggling and all you could use is a kind word. If all you ever gave was negativity, why are you expecting positivity in that moment? Be the joy, the change you want to see in the world. Be. We want to thank you from Radio Cave, from Joy Smiles Art, and all of the sponsors and participating parties. Grateful for Earthdance Global, grateful for Radio Cave, and grateful for every artist and musician and poetry reader and whatnot, magic creator, sharing their passions through this online festival. For those with issues that leave them mostly in their homes, I hope that this is a beautiful way that we can bring you into our art spaces, into our studios, into our homes, and into our hearts. Thank you so much for sponsoring, for donating, for being a part of Earthdance 2023, presented by Radio Cave and its other affiliates and sponsors. Thank you so much for finding joy on this beautiful evening. And remember, we have those three prizes. Please feel free to donate. And you can always include in your donation which prize that you are looking at, be it mine or someone else's. So thank you so much for everyone who is a member of our Facebook pages, our Facebook groups, who supports the ARC Wildlife Care and Sanctuary, Foundation of Families, Prayer for Peace 2023, Earthdance Global, and again, hashtag Wildlife Rescue Nexus, hashtag Joy Smiles Art, hashtag Radio Cave, hashtag Art Heals. Thank you and good night.